A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th March, on the front page you have RTI trumps Official Secrets Act, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court says that Official Secrets Act would not hold because RTI Act is in place. When government is asking the fuel pricing details to be kept a secret, Justice Joseph is talking about the RTI Act, how information has to be brought out in the open. And this is 6 dead as Mumbai footbridge collapses. So this is a Mumbai footover bridge which collapsed as such, resulting in 29 injured and many feared dead too. 6 persons were dead. Then below you have India wants visa free travel to Kartarpur. So this is regarding the Kartarpur Shrine, an important Sikh pilgrimage site in Pakistan. So, India-Pakistan are developing Kartarpur corridor for movement from India to Pakistan, and there were recently talks held, and India has asked Pakistan to grant visa-free travel rights to Indian pilgrims visiting the Kartarpur Shrine. So, this is India's proposal to Pakistan. Then below you have 23 opposition parties move court on EVVMs and VVPATs. So, electronic voting machines and voter verifiable paper on audit trail. So, these petitioners say are crucial, and Supreme Court has listed these cases for urgent hearing too. And below you have Supreme Court agrees to hear the Shillong Times editor's plea. So, Meghalaya High Court had called, had ordered against the editor, calling it to be contempt of court, and now you know, the Supreme Court is going to hear the case. Even there was an editorial in the Hindu on this matter. So it had also said that they would cancel their license, on which it is said that courts do not have that power to cancel license for contempt of court. There is punishment for contempt of court that can be awarded. On page 2 you have Bandi pollution. NGT refuses to waive rupees 20 crore fine on state. So this is National Green Tribunal which had slapped a fine of rupees 20 crore on Rajasthan government for not taking proper action to control pollution in the Bandi river by local textile industries. So government has asked for a waiver, but the National Green Tribunal did not budge. It said that it will be 20 crore fine for the state. On page 5 you have Bannerghatta eco-sensitive zone curtailed. So this is regarding Bannerghatta National Park's eco-sensitive zone. So here in Karnataka, majorly in Karnataka, this zone has been reduced by nearly 100 square kilometers. So citizens have also objected to this reduction. And this is fire breaks out in Bandipur again. So forest watchers and others have managed to douse this fire within hours now. So the second incident, first incident had resulted in huge acres of the forest being affected. On page 7 you have a climate vulnerability index for India on the anvil. So an online portal with district wise data is also on the pipeline. So this will give an idea about climate vulnerability in the country. So here you can see this is state wise vulnerability value shown here, with Assam and Mizoram being identified as most vulnerable to climate change. So this is a study done by various IITs and IISCs, and this is the result of that. Then this is collapsed bridge was declared safe by structural audit officials. So this is regarding the Mumbai footover bridge which collapsed. So you know, the structural audit as such had declared it safe. So now doubts are raised over consultants' report calling only for minor repairs. And below you have prices slashed for 463 cancer medicines. So National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority has reduced MRP of 463 non-scheduled cancer medicines now. So earlier too we had seen such a news, and now more cancer medicines price have been reduced. On the editorial page, the first editorial is China's blog. So this is regarding China's technical blog on declaring Masood Azhar, the leader of Jaish-e-Mohammed, as an international terrorist. So, the editorial says its decision on Masood Azhar is shocking, but India must keep up persuasive diplomacy. Then this is horror in Pollachi. So this is a case of sexual assault and blackmail in Pollachi in Tamil Nadu, which has made headlines. So guilty need to be brought to book is what the editorial argues. Then the lead article as such is an abhorrent and unjust device. So this is regarding death penalty. So the article says retention of the death penalty utterly undermines India's moral foundations. And this is from Revolutions to Roses. So it says Women's Day should be an occasion to ponder over how much more is to be done for gender justice. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, there will be a question on which there will be views, counter views given. So here this is, will a court mandated mediation on Ayodhya solve the issue? So there are two viewpoints here given. So Supreme Court's attempt at mediation has a share of supporters and critics. So that is shown here. On page 10 you have, government defends electoral bond scheme in Supreme Court. So electoral bonds have been introduced to promote transparency in funding and donations received by political parties is what the government is telling the Supreme Court on this matter. So you should know about electoral bonds, it is very very important. So that is how donations can be made to political parties now. So through online, you know, through banks. So transfer of money to banks. On international page you have, MPs reject second referendum proposal. So now in UK, the members of parliament have rejected that there will be a second referendum. So Brexit referendum and the decision on it is final. Now only how Brexit will take place is a question which haunts the country. And below you have, 11-year-old sues UK US government. So this is Levi Rahim, an 11-year-old kid who lives on a barrier island separating the coast of Florida from Atlantic Ocean, and now he has filed a lawsuit against US government over climate change. On business page you have, disinvestment target within reach, center. So far the government has collected a total of 56,473 crore against the target of 80,000 crore. So this is regarding that. And this is, Max 8 design flawed, experts. So experts say that Boeing Max 8 design is flawed. Boeing stretched limits while designing new version. Then on page 14 you have, wholesale price inflation quickens to 2.93% in Feb 2019. So this is regarding WPI. So wholesale price inflation actually has increased presently because of food and fuel prices going high. So this is the entire, you know, month wise graph given here regarding WPI, how it has gone from around 4% to down to 2% now, from, you know, September to October 2018 to now in Feb 2018. So inflation has fallen over the months, and now it has increased a little. And below you have, don't suppress data, economists tell government. So economists say that any statistics that doubt central government's achievements seem to get revised or stifled. So this, you know, is been the point has been made by the economists that government should not suppress data. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website ahr.com. And here in the current affairs section, you can have daily PDFs downloaded. Also, you can get the detailed current affairs video too. So, the headlines video is only the headlines, but by the end of the day, we have a detailed current affairs coverage which is provided here. So, even sample video is available here. And also, this is the detail of the course, current affairs full course. So, that is it. Thank you.